Hey guys, this is Nathan, and welcome back to HermitPack. So I have been looking at this over and over and over. Every time that I come over here, I keep looking at this, and this view just does not get old. I mean, this is just amazing. So I've got a couple of ideas of what I want to work on today. We can continue the path up to the dam, and I want to build a little house up there for the dam keeper. And also we could work on the village itself and start getting some of those buildings rebuilt in the style that we're looking for. Or we have the path over here. And now this was an idea that I just came up with a little while ago. So this path ends right here, and I was saying that this path is going to go up onto this hill here, and didn't know what I was going to do over here. Well, I've come up with an idea. So up in here, we start getting up into the mountains, and this is pretty cool. We could bring the path all the way up here into the mountains, and up here we can build some mines. And I thought that was a pretty cool idea. So if we come way up in here, we could sink a tunnel into the side of the mountain and put a whole bunch of like coal or iron or copper, something like that, and say that that is our mine for the city. And I think that would be pretty cool. And then another thing that we can do is we can set up a stone quarry and say that that is where the stone for the city is coming from. You see, I'm trying to be a little bit more storytelling this time around than I have ever been in any of my previous series. Before, it's always just been about surviving, building, making the things that I need to do what I want to do. This time, I really want there to be kind of a story behind what I'm doing. So, yeah, I'm not entirely sure which one of those we're going to do or how many of them we'll be able to work on, but I do want to do that dam keeper's house first. That's the first thing that I want to do because, well, I want to be able to call this dam and aqueduct system completed. So I think I'm going to gather up some resources. I'll do a little research on what kind of a house I want that to look like, and I will meet you guys over there. So I came back to spawn to mend my elytra, and I found this. Now I've been trying to figure out what is wrong with the spawner here, and the only thing that I can think is the update has screwed up the inverted conveyors. So what I'm going to have to do here is just block this and keep the mobs from coming through, and then we're going to have to rebuild this a little differently. So I think I'm gonna get away from here real quick and get those mobs to despawn. I'll see what I can figure out to get that working properly again, and then I'll be back in a little bit. So I think I've got a pretty simple solution here. I put the golden spike above the conveyor belt, so I'm gonna go ahead and break this block out. I'm gonna put this carpet down here so that I don't end up with mob spawns there, and move off to the side here, break that, and I have a spot here that's still open, and wow, the XP. So yep, that's working. It takes up less room in the building now too. The only thing is the baby zombies can knock the mobs back down, unfortunately. But I have a little bit of stuff to fix up there on the top to get the ceiling fixed. Actually, he's not knocking them down. That is surprising. So it is working just fine, but so yep, I will go ahead and get this ceiling fixed up, and then I'll figure out what we're going to do next. Well, I'm here with Wandering One in the Nether. We've been kind of messing around here with this wither skeleton spawner that he set up. And this was just a quick and dirty spawner that he set up with one spawner up here, and did a little bit of stuff here to automate it. So we have mechanical users here with our swords in them. And then we have a collection system and a sorting system. And right now we have 365 wither skeleton skulls, and that number just keeps going up. So this was a great idea, Craig. That's all I can say.
Oh, yeah.
There's...
We're going to have a few nether stars maybe this week.
Yeah, I think now we need to figure out how to farm the wither or the wither bosses without blowing things up.
Oh, I know how to do that. Let me look quick.
I know there used to be blocks that wither bosses couldn't break.
There is one I'm trying to find.
Reinforced obsidian is witherproof. Yeah,
that's it.
Dark.
It's not that hard to make either.
Yeah, a lot of dark steel is about all it looks like. Yeah. But so we have a compressed torturino and a regular torturino up here. We're running at 900 on the compressed and 400 on the regular. And we've got three spawners in here now. And the three mechanical users seem to be able to keep up pretty good. So, yeah, I didn't even look. 726 arrows, 3,000 solidified experience, 500 drops of evil. I don't know what we're going to do with those. Necrotic bones for days, ribs, withered ribs. Yeah, I don't think we're going to have any problems there. And then at the end, we did put a trash can so that all of the armor, stone swords, bows, all of that junk goes bye-bye. No use plugging up a system with it. So I think this may be the system that I use to solve the problems at the overworld mob spawner as well. But yeah, that's kind of a neat little solution there.
We're going to have to make more swords, so we're not using ours.
Well, no, it's great because we're getting experience on them too. The only problem with it is the fact that they're also taking durability damage, but a little bit of reinforced will help that.
Yeah.
All right, guys, well, I'll be back in a little bit. Well, I've been doing a lot of fiddling with this wither skeleton spawner, and yeah, we definitely have a viable working system here now. So I did put in a coal generator here. I'm using the coal that we're getting from the wither skeletons to power this, and then I have this screen controller, and that is controlling this screen here. Now this screen has a button module and a redstone module, and I know that I haven't gone into RF tools at all. But this stuff here works together. We have the Torturino button with no label on the button, and then we have the label being 3600% and on and off in red and green for the redstone module, and that is powering our Torturino up there. So if we click this button and turn this on, we can see now the skeletons start coming like crazy. Now these guys take fall damage to half a heart, which makes it to where I can just do one swipe and it kills the great majority of them. Of course, the armor messes with that. I have these currently set to always on, but I want to turn those off for a bit because this is just absolutely phenomenal what we get out of this. So I'm going to let this kind of run here. Now I did make a few more swords because I was going to be putting these in the mechanical users, but now that I've set this up for fall damage, we really don't need those. But I had made these Manulan swords. They're a lot better than what we had originally. And yeah, we're getting tons of experience, tons of drops. And yeah, here in just a second, I'll show you what I've got here. So we have, and it still seems like one of these is working. Oh, this one. Let's go redstone on. So now we have that. So this thing is sucking up the items. We have an advanced item collector putting the items into a diamond chest. And then we have Ender IO pipes pulling the items out. We have our items that we want to keep, and then we have a trash can over here to delete things like our bows and swords and armor. But this one here has our wither skeleton skulls in it, and we have over 1,000 wither skeleton skulls. Now, I went ahead and filled my inventory with netherrack, and this is just to keep me from picking up any of the items. And you can see it tried to pick them up there, but I couldn't. So we have over 1,000 of the skulls. We have 1,900 of the withered ribs. So that will allow us to turn these 394 regular skeleton skulls into wither skeleton skulls as well. Then also we have 1,900 of the necrotic bones, 29,000 regular bones. We have the 12,500 coal, 3,400 drops of evil, almost 6,000 arrows, and then almost 20,000 solidified experience. So yeah, this thing is really pumping out items. I have 109 experience levels. We have 207 in our obelisk. So let's go ahead and add all of these. That takes us to 228 levels in our obelisk. So this is working really, really good. I don't think we're going to have to worry about wither skeleton skulls for a long time, but I think this is probably going to be where we're going to do our stuff for experience grinding and things like that. And because we have such a low level of damage that we're dealing to the mobs, we're not doing much damage to our swords. So you can see here, my sword, my normal iron broadsword, takes no damage. The experience will fix it really fast, even with mending moss level 1. So this is working just beautifully. A couple episodes from now, we'll have to look at getting a spawner set up for the wither skeletons, or the wither bosses. And then we'll have unlimited nether stars, because right now we've got enough here for over 300 nether stars. Now that just seems ridiculous. But yeah, I think now that I've got this pretty well sorted out, of course we're going to have to make this look a little better in the future, but now that we have this sorted out, I think I'm going to head back to the overworld and we're going to work a little bit more on our farm areas. So I have been looking around this area trying to decide where we're going to build this little hut for the dam keeper. And I think what we're going to do is build it up in this area. So I'm going to have to remove this tree and this little one here, but I want to keep this big tree here because that looks really cool right next to the dam. And also it has a whole bunch of big open space inside of it. That's pretty cool. But so I'll need to remove these two trees, and then I'll have to do a little bit of terraforming here to make a space for the house, which kind of sucks because, I mean, this really looks nice. I mean, my only other option is to go on the other side, and that would require tunneling up through the mountain, and then maybe I could put it up over there, but this feels like more of a logical location for it. The only thing is, this one is going to need a fairly sizable area, probably at least about, I don't know, 10 by 15 or more. So, I don't know, I'm going to lay this out and see if there's even a large enough space here. We may have to take and cut this ridge back if we're going to do that, and I really don't like that idea too much. But I'll see what I can figure out, and then I'll be back in a little bit. Well, I am really sorry for that cranial flatulence there. I don't have to build it up there. I got to thinking about it. We could take the path through the aqueduct and come over here. We have a large area over here that we can build on. So, yeah, that means a lot less terraforming, and we have much more space over here to use. So I think what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove these carpets here. This is probably going to be what we're going to use for the path. We're still going to have to carry the path up to the dam, but yeah, we'll not worry about destroying all of that hill. We're going to go ahead and terraform this up. Which actually makes a bit more sense, because now we can make it to where the river seems more like it's supposed to be going that way. But I am probably going to have to cut a couple of these trees down in order to get a spot for it. So, yeah, I'm not going to bore you guys with the terraforming this time around. I know that it was probably informative to some people in the last episode, but I don't want to make a habit of it. So I'm going to get the terraforming done here, and then we'll take a look at the building process on this house. So I'm pretty satisfied with the way the terraforming has gone here. I basically just extended this hill out further on both sides here, and I kind of constrained the river a little more too. I kind of feel like this should be a little bit more meandering, but that would be something that we'd have to look at a later date. So I think we have enough room here that I'm going to start building our house. Now we're going to have the same type of foundation that we had on the other one, but we're going to use cobblestone this time instead of the chiseled smooth stone like we did last time. So I am going to remove this grass block and place a cobble underneath it, and then we're going to run a cobble line across here, and then it looks like this one, only this one. And so then we will turn this and go this way. Now this one will not have the little jog in the foundation like we had in the other one, so that's going to simplify this part of the build a little bit. We're going to go those. And I'm not sure how wide we need to go here. So, yeah, I think I'm actually going to add one more here. And then we're going to connect this back this way. So, I'm not going to fill everything in with cobblestone here, because I'm not entirely sure how much of it we're going to need cobblestone. So the path is coming in here. We're going to want that to come into the entrance of the house, and yeah, I had originally planned for the house to be facing that way, because facing into the aqueduct kind of sucks. Now I guess what we could do is have it come around this way, and we could have a little bit of a walkway on the front and have the house facing that way. That might look good. So if we're going to do that, we're going to need a few blocks out here to be the entrance area, and then the rest of this is pretty much going to be the house. So I guess we're going to have to go a fair amount further back here. If we go one more block, we're going to be literally up against the aqueduct, so I don't think we want to do that. We'll go ahead and go like this, and now the rest of these blocks can be replaced with cobblestone. So let's go ahead and do that. And yeah, you know what? We're just gonna fill this whole thing in with cobble. We have our builder's wand. We'll go ahead and make short work of this. There we go. So there's that. Now we need to start laying out the house itself. Now this one we're gonna be making out of white hardened clay. And once again, we're gonna hug the edge of the foundation. And I came up one block further than I wanted to. So now, how many blocks wide did I go here? Huh, I went an odd number. That is perfect. So we'll go ahead and lay this out. And yeah, that's as far back as we can go. This isn't a very large house, but still, I think it's going to look kind of cool. So we're going to go up two here and make a little window there on the front. And you know what? This guy would want to be able to see the dam. So we're going to put several windows on this side as well. That might actually be too many. Let's go ahead and close that one. The back side, there really would be no point for a window because you're looking at the aqueduct. So we'll do that. And then on this side, we'll put the two small windows in again. And then those on the front, we'll go ahead and put that there. All right, so this is a fairly, yeah, this is actually a perfectly square house. So that kind of sucks, actually. So now what we want to do is we are going to put a roof on here that is rather unique. So this is a roof style that was found in a lot of Roman builds but I have not used it at all. So we're gonna kind of try to replicate this as best we can. The building really should be bigger for this, but yeah, we'll just have to kind of do what we can. I wish we weren't so close to the aqueduct. And you know what? Yeah, I think I'm gonna do that. I am going to extend the terraforming just ever so slightly further so that we can extend the length of this house by two more blocks. So I'm going to do that and I'll be right back. There, now that the terraforming has been extended and the river has been slightly diverted again, I think we can finally build the roof that I'm wanting here. So this section here, we're actually going to go up by one more block here on the back. And then this is going to get a shed type roof. So yeah, this is a little bit different, but this is kind of the way that this would have been built. So we probably could have used half slabs for this section, but we're gonna go ahead and use the stairs. It'll make it a little bit taller, more exaggerated on the build features, but I think it'll still look okay. So last section here, and then we're going to be building the rest of the roof up against this, but it's not going to be just a standard roof. So one thing that we need to do here, and yeah, I know this is going to make for very cramped quarters inside, but we're going for the outside appearance more than the inside because, well, Minecraft doesn't allow us to have really accurate interior builds unless we're huge on our building scale. So, darn it. So we need one more block here just to kind of cover the edge of this. And we're going to put this in here and hopefully this will work. So we'll get this little piece of roof in here. And then what we're going to do is we are going to make, well, I guess I did use something like this on the insulae, but yeah, I haven't really used it heavily. So probably going to have to use some chisels and bits to make this look right. But we're going to put now an elevated section of roof that is aiming inward. And now, the only reason that I can think that they would do this in their buildings was to try to collect rainwater. And, you know, water was a pretty big deal to them. And that's part of the reason why I've built this. But so that's the way that this is going to look. Now, what I really want is to have a little bit of our white hardened clay on the face of these guys. So I think we're going to just quickly do a little bit of chisels and bits. If I can find my chisels and bits stuff. So we're going to take a block of clay, and I think one block ought to do it. We're going to pick up one whole block of white hardened clay. Then we're going to take this and we're going to do with a drawn region. So we're going to take this and what did we just do? Close that back up. So what we're going to do is first we're going to we're breaking the block? Why are we breaking the block? Let's change this to the drawn region. And we'll first remove a section here, or can we not remove it? No, we can't remove a section from those. Darn it, I think I had seen that before, but I'd forgotten. So we're going to take and we're going to place a little bit of a chisels and bits border here. And it looks like we are limited to four blocks in length that chisels and bits will do. We're going to leave four pixels sticking up above. And then we're going to continue this all the way around this portion of the house. So I think this will look pretty cool. We'll have to get this all done and then see how it looks. But we're also going to do this then on this other portion as well. So there's the four block limit. There we go. So it's too bad we can't do that with the hardened clay. So now this section will need that as well. And we may have to get some more bits. Well, that didn't work. So let's go ahead and get back up here. How many bits do we have left? Not very many, but we might have enough. Let's go ahead and try this again, because we're going to have to do a whole bunch of this here. So 4 pixels down. Did I do 4 or 5 here? I did 4. Okay. So probably have to put this continuing further down. I'm not sure that it'll be very noticeable from the ground. Definitely won't be noticeable from the air. Oh, well, I didn't do 5 here, or 4 here. I only did 5, or whatever. I did 5 instead of 4. Okay, so that should pretty well be most of this done. Now, the only thing that's really left is they would have had some pillars inside of here. Unfortunately, I don't think we have the ability to make clay fence posts, so we'll have to do that with chisels and bits if we're going to do it. Or we can just leave this interior for now, and sometime at a later date we can go around and start doing some decorating. But let's go ahead and fly up here and see what this looks like. Yeah, I definitely think that we should have used the other, the half slabs for the back portion, but that's still a pretty cool looking house. So let's go ahead and fly over here and land on the aqueduct. It actually looks a little bit big. Yeah, it feels a little out of place. So I think I may have to go back over there. I'm going to cut the top of it back off, and I'm going to redo that, see what I can come up with. I'm going to try to keep the same basic shapes, but I'm going to try to make it shorter. So I'm going to work on that, and I'll be right back. Well, that is much better. That's all I can say. So we're no longer standing up above the aqueduct, and this looks a lot better. So what I did, I cut an entire layer of the white hardened clay out, and then I changed to half slabs instead of stairs for the roof. I still used the stairs for the little center bit, but all I can say is this really feels cozy in here. It's a good thing that we're not really going for usefulness, we're just going for appearance. But still, this is a bit on the extreme side. But I think I'm going to just go ahead and drop a couple of torches in here just so that we don't have any spawns around here. And I like to take a look at the map whenever I'm done building something and see what this looks like for nighttime. And all I can say is this looks really cool. So we've got just a small amount of light around here. I also put a little bit of light on the dam itself. And so that is pretty cool. And what I may have to do is wait for nighttime, and we'll take a look at this when there's no sunlight. But I know we are really close to time on the episode. So yeah, I'm going to wait for night to fall, which is, we're not even noon yet. And I'll see you guys in a little bit. Well, I just wish there was more ways that we could play around with lighting without having to worry about mob spawns, because that looks really cool. So yeah, we've got this all set up here. I did a little bit of the landscaping around here, did a lot of bone mealing, and made a lot of tall grass along the river, because that makes sense. And then I went ahead and put in a small garden back here. Well, this is probably one of the largest ones that I've done so far, but it's got multiple tiers to it, which is something that I haven't done yet. And I put some rice right along the river. Yeah, cute little touch there. We also put in some watermelons and pumpkins, which is something that I haven't done before, and it looks pretty cool. So also we have the path running up here to the dam now, and the dam is lit up, and so the dam keeper could see the dam from his house and could tell if there's water coming out of here or not, and it'd be really easy for him to come up here. That's exactly what we're looking for. Now, here fairly soon, we're going to have to start bringing villagers out to these houses. But I think that's going to have to be for another episode, because time is definitely fun when you're having flies. So if you enjoyed the episode, don't forget to give a thumbs up. If you're new to the channel, don't forget to subscribe. If you have any thoughts or comments, leave that down below, and I will see you next time. Bye!